Look at here.
Oh, my. They've got that, their symbolic flag. I don't know what they think it represents, but they are just symbolizing the fact that they are dominating. They own Bob Armstrong.
Gracie has a tennis racket, and look at him go.
Gracie's brother has got Cornell's tennis racket. And the gangsters have done their damage. They've hurt Scotty's knee. They busted Tracy open. They beat up Cornette, and they buried Bob Armstrong under that gangsta flag.
Don't change the channel as I flip on around. You're about to see the hottest show in town. The biggest stars and the biggest brawls. The biggest hits and the biggest falls. Non-stop action, no messing around. Pretty soon they're coming to your town. The way you like it, way it used to be. Smoky Mountain Wrestling's on TV.
Hello again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jim Ross, along with Les Thatcher, and welcome you to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We've got a great broadcast at the top of the program. You saw what happened here last week when Bob Armstrong was buried under the flag of the gangsters. As a result of that, Jim Cornette is asked to have a meeting with Bob Armstrong and Tracy Smothers. We'll have that for you later in the program on videotape. Plus, we've got a big tag team matchup involving the Dynamic Duo.
That's right. We're going to see Al Snow and Unabomb in action today. And, of course, maybe Snow's even going to wrestle on this one.
Plus, ladies and gentlemen, highlights from Sunday, Bloody Sunday, as we promised, and a Beat the Champ matchup. Bad Boy Billy Black in action for his first title defense. And we'll have all the action for you right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team match. Introducing first, total combined weight of 462 pounds, George South and Anthony Michaels.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, there you hear the music, the dynamic duo of simply sensational Al Snow and the huge giant, Unabomb. As you heard, they'll take on George South and Anthony Michaels. You know, ladies and gentlemen, during March Madness, the dynamic duo was signed to meet with the Rock and Roll Express in an elimination tag team matchup for the Smoky Mountain Tag Titles. We're going to hear some pre-recorded comments from the Rock and Roll Express a little bit later in this segment. So you'll want to stay tuned for that.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, total combined weight of 574 pounds, simply sensational Al Snow and the Demon of Destruction, Unabomb.
No less, I've been around a lot of big athletes in my career, and I got near, somewhat near Unabomb before we went on the air today, and it's Al Snow coming over here for it. This guy's about 7 feet.
Hey, Jimmy,
tall.
How you doing?
I see Al starting this match.
Hey, Uncle Fester, what's up?
I thought this was a tag team match.
It is a tag team match.
So what are you doing over here then?
Gosh, Jim, do I have to tell you everything?
Well, I mean, it's
I'm trying to prove a point here. We have that elimination tag match with Ricky and Robert.
During March Madness, I'm aware of that.
During March Madness, that's right. See, you're catching on. I'm showing you the way.
Thank you.
I'm trying to prove a point here. That Unabomb doesn't need me up there. He just needs me down here to lead the way. Well, Ricky and Robert don't stand a chance.
This is not Ricky and Robert. This is George South and Anthony Michaels.
You're very astute. Let's not beat a dead horse. But then again, let's not talk about your sex life either, Jim.
Well, you're the guy that likes to talk about the sex life. That's not something that Les and I...
Well, you're right. That's something you and Les don't, you know...
We don't talk about on television. Boy, this Unabomb is an awesome, awesome competitor. I can tell you that. He is, Les, where I was getting ready to tell you before Mr. Snow joined. This guy's just about 7 feet tall.
Yes, he is just about 7 feet tall.
And a very tight 300 pounds. I mean, this guy is lean. He could actually carry another 20, 25 pounds on that frame if he wanted.
Yeah, he could carry another 20, 25 pounds. I think that's what Ricky weighs. Isn't it about 20 or 25 pounds?
What do you weigh, Al?
What business is of yours?
I was wondering what
we're
took him to
book.
Carry
we
you.
We want to know.
None of your business. I don't give out information like that just to anybody.
Nice move there by
Anthony. Hey, come on now. That's it. Yeah, nice move. Big deal.
Michaels had the advantage for about 8 seconds.
And that's about all that Ricky and Robert are going to have, too, about 8 seconds.
Well, I have to tell you something. It's going to be
great, baby.
It's going to be difficult to beat both Morton and Gibson. And
it's not going to be nothing because we did the thing, did it already before. We divided and we conquered.
That's
it's
going to
be difficult beating both of us, Jim.
That's why you're down here? That's called a divided offense, or what exactly is that?
It's called unnecessary offense. See, I'm trying to be nice. I'm trying to keep from having these two guys go to the hospital, because it's bad enough they got to face him. It'd be even worse if they had to face me.
Does he get offended that he's doing all the work and you're just sitting over here talking?
He's a great guy. We've got a certain understanding. Go for it, baby.
You like it, Glenn?
I'll be right back, okay?
Yeah, right. Thanks. Don't hurry.
Well, is Al actually going to see action here?
I have no idea what he's going to do. Unabom has got Anthony Michaels beat, obviously, with that Unabom.
Look.
And, oh, my. That's a great move. I don't care. You may not like the guy. That's a great move.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Unabom and Al Snow.
Now, what's he going to do now? George South being held there. George is helpless. He may be going south. There's a drop kick. Oh, my. What an awesome drop kick. Look at the little kip up.
Yes.
Hey, I tell you something. Ricky and Robert are going to be in for a real challenge here.
It's going to be a battle.
We may be looking at the next Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. This Unabom is unbelievable. You know, you got to wonder, ladies and gentlemen, our fan poll question of the week on the Smoky Mountain Hotline. Do you think Unabom can be defeated? Can Unabom be defeated? We'd like to hear your vote. Your vote does count at 1-900-73-SMOKY. And so give us a call to the hotline. Got a lot of news on the hotline this week as well. And as we take you now to some pre-recorded comments from Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, the legendary Rock and Roll Express.
You know, coming up at March Madness, Robert and I have a tag team elimination match with Unabom and sensational Al Snow. But you see, in all these matches, Al Snow, you're always standing behind Unabom. And no matter what the outcome of the match is going to be, it's going to be 2-on-1. And we're hoping that Robert and I get rid of Unabom early in the match. That way, we'll both be on you. There's no place to hide. But on the other hand, it could come down to only one of us in the ring gets both of them. But you guys are going to find out. Rock and Roll Express has been together for 13 years. You guys have been together for 13 days. Brother, it's going to come down to tag team action, Robert. We're going to do all our tag team stuff when we step in that ring. We're going to find out what you guys are really made out of right here at March Madness.
Now you can own the greatest wrestling card of all time on videotape. It's the Night of the Legends. Join the sellout crowd in Knoxville for all the action and the memories. Road Warrior Hawk, the Funk Brothers, the Heavenly Bodies, Dick Slater and Bob Orton, Ronnie Garvin and the Stomper, Freebird Terry Gordy, Bob Armstrong, the Rock and Roll Express, Dirty White Boy, and more. Plus the Knoxville Wrestling Hall of Fame ceremony with the Legends. Profiles and interviews not seen on TV. Commentary by Jim Ross and Les Thatcher. This is the complete card. All matches uncut. Order now. You'll receive a free souvenir program from the Night of Legends with rare photos and profiles. Each tape set comes in library cases suitable for storage. You'll receive a free catalog on other SMW videotapes. 2 VHS tapes, almost 4 hours of action in library cases, plus a free program and free catalog. And we pay the postage. Send $29.95 in check or money order to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37816. Relive the memories.
Welcome back, everybody. Jim Ross, Les Thatcher back with you. Wouldn't you say that Boo Bradley's career in the last few weeks has had a series of peaks and valleys?
It certainly has. And for a man who barely could tie his own shoestrings a few months ago, or at least we thought that, this guy has come a long way, Jim.
We're going to hear some comments from Boo Bradley in a few moments, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to take you back right now to Sunday, Bloody Sunday, that matchup involving Boo Bradley and Chris Candido. And then we're going to show you what happened last week when Boo Bradley lost the television title to Bad Boy Billy Black.
Wait a minute. There is Tammy Fitch at ringside. What is she doing here? Tammy Fitch has been suspended from Smoky Mountain Wrestling. What is she doing at ringside? Bradley doesn't see her, and Bradley misses there. And Tammy Fitch, now Mark Curtis sees her, and Fitch has something behind her back, tosses that to Candido. Curtis didn't see it. Chris Candido has it from Tammy Fitch. He drops it. It's some of that hairspray. Some of that Tammy Fitch hairspray. And hey, how do you like that, Tammy? Get some hairspray. Boo Bradley sprays Tammy Fitch, but now Candido able to body slam Bradley. Candido off the top rope. Bradley able to get off, yanks the chain, and Candido is down. On the chain went Candido. Count of two, count of three. Count of three, and Boo Bradley has won this match. As Candido lands on the steel chain and is counted for a count of three.
According to the stipulation, Chris Candido
And Billy Black caught Boog coming in left foot. Got him in the face with it. Billy Black going upstairs. What's he going to do here? He didn't learn this in a swamp. And nobody
home.
He went for a moonsault and nobody home. It looks like he may have dislocated his knee there. I'm not sure. He came down. He's grabbing his knee. And Boog Bradley should follow up right here. He's got Billy Black in a compromised position. It's all Boog Bradley's match from this point forward, Les.
You know, from that angle, he could have cracked that kneecap, but
Bradley's concerned about Billy Black.
Look here!
Hey! He got the bulldog. He wasn't hurt at all. Boog Bradley turned around and he got beat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match and new Beat the Champ TV title holder, Bad Boy.
And Black Billy just bailed Black out over that chopped rope. Nothing wrong with that leg, just a wily gentleman from the swamp.
He outsmarted Boog Bradley and took advantage of Boog Bradley's kind nature. That's exactly what he did.
Hello? Hey, is this on over here?
Yeah, will you go already?
Okay, I'm sorry. Hi, everybody. This is Boog Bradley again, and I'm here today to talk to you about something that happened on the TV when I had that TV championship thing, whatever that is. But they called me a champion, so I defended my belt against a guy named Billy Black. And Billy Black, you know, he was a good wrestler, and I tried to treat him like a good wrestler and try to wrestle him. But, you know, I'm not a mean person. I try not to be a mean person. And when he was holding his leg like that, I thought he was really hurt, and I didn't want to hurt him. And then the next thing I know, I got dropped on my head from behind. And, you know, when I was growing up in Asbury, there's a lot of kids used to make fun of me. And they know how mean I can be when I throw them through a wall. And I don't want to do something like that, but Billy Black, you're going to end up making me do something like that to you just because you had to trick me like that, because everyone should wrestle fair. But I got to go now. So everybody have a good day and eat your peas. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing a challenger weighing 231 pounds from Beckley, West Virginia, Brian Logan.
Brian Logan will challenge the Beat the Champ Television Champion. He won it here last week. He has seen nothing but good things in the ring. For the most part, from Bad Boy Billy Black.
We haven't seen this. What is in that coach?
Nobody wants to get enough for you.
He took advantage of the naivety of Boog Bradley here last week. I felt so sorry for Boog Bradley to lose that television title the way that he did.
And ladies and gentlemen, introducing the champ, weighing 238 pounds from Willacoochee, Georgia, Bad Boy Billy Black.
From South Georgia, down in the swamp country.
That's a lot easier to say than Willacoochee.
Yeah, you noticed that, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
That Willacoochee line will be the best of them.
Tommy Noe got Willacoochee in there real good.
He's very eloquent.
He's
nice big block takeover by Brian Logan. Let's see if Brian Logan could pull the upset.
Logan takes it to him right from that opening bell, and young Brian improves each and every outing, Jim, and he's met up with some very, very tough athletes over the last few months.
Well, upsets can happen, ladies and gentlemen, and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about when you see our report from Sunday, Bloody Sunday.
Did you see that?
That was a martial arts kick.
It certainly
was. What did he learn? He didn't learn that in South Georgia. Oh, spinning wheel kick there by Bad Boy Billy Black. I don't think we know all we need to know about this man. Some of that martial arts maneuvering, I don't think you learn in South Georgia. One, two, and a near fall there. And all due respect to, I live in Georgia, so not in South Georgia, but I don't know too many martial artists in the southern part of the state.
You've never heard of the Willacoochee Martial Arts Academy?
One, two. Almost an upset right there. Don't have
two.
I don't even know where in the heck Willacoochee is. I need to get me one of those road atlases and look that up. It's on there. Fans, if you can look it up on your maps, let Les and I know just exactly where it is. Drop us a line. Bad Boy Billy Black certainly with a... He just outsmarted Boog Bradley. That's the way that I know how to put it.
This guy's full of surprises. You see the martial arts, you see good wrestling moves, he's a brawler.
And he's got a mean streak.
And a very crafty gentleman. Found out with Boo last week.
You're right, Les. The thing that we need to document, folks, he doesn't like anybody. This is not a likable guy. I'm not sure Brian Logan's kick had the effect that Billy Black did earlier or that.
No comparison there.
No, sir. knocked the taste right out of his mouth there.
Logan's was a glancing blow, but Black certainly wasn't. Reverse, neck breaker, excuse me.
Got him right here, locked up, 1-2. Well, Brian Logan's hanging tough. Stranger things have happened, as you will see on Sunday, Bloody Sunday's highlights.
You know, the thing that I'm wondering about on Black here, Jim, is he's been around about 3 weeks now. And as of yet, we haven't seen him really point a finger at any of the top.
Oh, 1-2. Just about had him there, Les.
He certainly did. But Black hasn't really pointed a finger at any of the top athletes in the Smoky Mountain area. Been very low profile in that particular area.
Now, Brian Logan took another chance, and that didn't pay off for him. He got to wonder if it's just a matter of time. That's a nice suplex. Side suplex.
He didn't learn that in Willacooch either.
No, as a matter of fact, in Japan, they call that the Saito suplex. Oh, elbow off the top. Yeah, tell me it's over. And it is.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match has still beat the Champ TV title holder, Bad Boy Billy Black.
Well, Bad Boy Billy Black continues his winning ways here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. He's the reigning Smoky Mountain Television Champion as we take another look.
And Bad Boy is on the top, coming home with the elbow. Drops it on Brian Logan. Watch him as he hooks the arm and leg. Mark Curtis tolls the three count. The TV champion comes up a winner. And right now, Jim Ross is going to talk to Bad Boy Billy Black.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here with the Smoky Mountain Television Champion. I was just wondering one thing. You're from down there in the swamps of South Georgia. Where did you learn those martial arts moves?
That ain't none of your business, Jim Ross, where I learned the martial arts moves. I may be one of the baddest men ever stepped foot in that ring, but you'll never know where I learned it, Jim Ross. Just like y'all never know where I learned what's in this bag right here. Because I'm a man of many secrets, and that's the way I like it to be left. So stay out my face, Jim Ross.
Well, no problem there. Ladies and gentlemen, here's more on the Red Hot Smoky Mountain Hotline. We appreciate your call this weekend.
Hi, everybody. This is Jim Ross, and now you can keep informed on all the happenings in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's the new Smoky Mountain Wrestling Hotline. Get news from all the federations with me, Jim Ross, and the real truth with the Louisville Slugger, Jim Cornette. Vote on the fans poll, and let Smoky Mountain Wrestling know what you think. Send a personal message to any Smoky Mountain star. Hear a schedule of live events. It's news, it's fun, it's 1-900-73-SMOKY. That's 1-900-73-SMOKY. Kids, get your parents' permission before calling.
Fans, welcome to this special edition of Confrontation, where wrestling manager Jim Cornette has asked for some time with the commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Bullet Bob Armstrong. Mr. Cornette.
You know, first of all, I know you don't want to be here, and I know we look like the odd couple here. I look like Emmett Kelly, and you look like Charles Bronson. But let me explain something to you, Bob Armstrong. You know, it's not been real easy for me the past couple of months either in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Now, I know you've done a couple of things for me, but you haven't really done it for me. You've done it in the name of justice. You've done it in the name of fair play. You would have helped out any bum on the street instead of Jim Cornette. And I know there's still that animosity there. And believe me, I feel a little bit for you, too. But it hadn't been that easy for me because I got no locker room to go to at these matches anymore. Because I've been sitting there in a locker room with the dirty white boy who hates my guts. I've been sitting there with Tracy and Scott, who, oh yeah, sure, they'll talk to me and everything. And the Rock and Roll Express, they help me out a little bit. But they don't really want to be around me. It's not like it's pal, pal, buddy. Buddy can't go on the other side because there's the gangsters. Candido's gone. None of the other guys really care what happened. Bruiser went off and left me. Nobody really cares for me over there, and I can't sit there with the gangsters, so I got to sit on the other side of the fence and look at everybody say, yeah, that Cornette, I remember the time he jacked me around. So it ain't been real easy for me. But I want to remind you, I want to remind everybody what the gangsters have done in the past, starting at Christmas night, Christmas Chaos, when they beat me half to death, busted my head open, hurt my leg. Then they went on and they got Steve, and they kneecapped him with that billy stick. And then they got a hold of Scott, and they did the same thing. They roughed you up a little bit, too. Oh, yeah, they systematically went about knocking out the entire Armstrong family, or trying to, but you've been a real roadblock in that path for them. But they've done a lot of things to a lot of people. And most recently, a couple of incidents, first at Sunday Bloody Sunday in Knoxville, and I think everybody may not have had a chance to see that, when you were the referee, when I asked you to be the special referee for the six-man tag with me and the Bodies against the gangsters, I want everybody to see what happened when that match was over with.
Meanwhile, Cornette staggers out, but still not close to making that all-important tag.
New Jack right in the face of Jim Cornette. Cornette again feels the wrath of the gangsters, as he has so often of late here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Armstrong blocks the punch there, saying, let the guy out of the corner. And New Jack doesn't like that one bit. There he gets a right hand in. And Cornette able to low blow New Jack. Well, whatever it takes to get out of there. And Cornette able to deliver one of those south of the border selections to get away from New Jack, and flips over and tags Tom Pritchard. Now you got all three gangsters in the ring, and Tom Pritchard is cleaning house. Pritchard laid out. And here comes New Jack, and Pritchard able to get out of harm's way. Last second maneuver by Tom Pritchard as New Jack was ready to come crashing down. Pritchard needs to make that tag. And now is his chance to do it if he can regain himself, because New Jack is also reeling in the corner. Pritchard inches over, makes the tag to the Gigolo. Mustafa tagged by New Jack, and Jimmy Del Rey, one on three, able to take advantage and go to work on Mustafa. Drop kick, gets into the midsection of D'Lo, and now goes after New Jack. Pritchard also into the ring. A sleeper, Jimmy Del Rey has it on New Jack. Meanwhile, D'Lo Brown is in. Cornette reaches into his clutch and throws some powder into the eyes of D'Lo Brown, who is then tossed out of the ring, and Jim Cornette is after him. Meanwhile, New Jack, Tom Pritchard, Jimmy Del Rey, and Mustafa are all in the ring. Bob Armstrong got that slapjack, leveled New Jack, and Jimmy Del Rey is able to cover him. They're kind of afraid. Well, New Jack went to the slapjack once too often, and the commissioner, Bob Armstrong, our special referee, was right there to rip it away, used it himself on New Jack, and Jimmy Del Rey for the cover in the count of three. But now it's so often the case, the gangsters go to work after the match is over. That chain around the neck of Bob Armstrong, and then the New Jack chain, the Mustafa slapjack right in to Bob Armstrong. D'Lo Brown with an elbow drop. Three on one as the Heavenly Bodies have been thrown out of the ring. And it's Bob Armstrong feeling the brunt of the gangsters.
You know, you said before that match the best team was going to win, and of course that's my opinion, the best team did, but you see what happened afterwards. You remember it, I remember it, everybody else does now. And something else, last week on television when I seconded your son Scott and Tracy Smothers against the gangsters, you got involved, and it was more humiliating than anything even I'd ever done to you when they buried you under that flag. I want to take a look at that and refresh your memory and everybody else's, because I got a proposal to make.
And I don't think they're anxious to put him away. Look at here.
He hits this. It's over, but he's not. Tracy Smothers looked up, threw that blood on his face, and saw what was happening. Able to roll toward the corner, away from the contact. Now, can he make the tag? Yes, he can.
Oh! Scotty Armstrong with a fire in his eye. Look at him go. Down goes New Jack Mustafa, and Scott Armstrong is lighting him up, Jim.
Armstrong taking on both of them while Tracy Smothers is trying to get it back together. Armstrong, the whip to the center of the ropes. Cody with a super kick. It could be over right there. Tracy Smothers back in the fight.
We've got a four-way again, and right now the Southern boys are pulling this one out of the fire. They have taken over, handled
it. Oh! He had him. Armstrong hit. Cornette just nailed D'Lo Brown, but it's too late. D'Lo hit Armstrong right in the leg with that blackjack.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the Gangstas.
Scott, he had him up for the slam and got Armstrong. Oh, he's getting him again. That blackjack. They're using that blackjack, and this crowd is getting irate.
D'Lo got the Cornette's knee.
Cornette now being manhandled by D'Lo Brown. The new Southern boys had the match won, but they lost, and look at the pounding. They're beating this kid's leg apart. Smothers, Buddy, and Batter on the outside. Cornette knocked down. The Gangsters are, I've never seen them more deadly than we're seeing right here.
They need to do something to put a stop to this. These guys could injure this man permanently.
Oh, they're trying to break his leg. They're trying to break Armstrong's leg. They want to break this guy Armstrong's leg. That's exactly what they're trying to do right here. Oh, this is chaos. Wait a minute. Here comes Bob. Here comes Mother Bob Armstrong, but with no baseball bat.
But he's got them hands on it, hung it on the other's wrist, and he is cleaning out.
But how long did he fight off three men? Armstrong, with the martial arts. He learned that in the Marine Corps. But how much? Oh, he may have gone as far as he could go right there. Mustafa Saeed. Picking up Bob. And slamming the veteran down to the canvas. Oh, this is dangerous right here, I'm telling you.
They are back in control again. How many guys are hurt at their gym? Only time's going to tell. But I'm afraid for Scott Armstrong, he could be out of wrestling permanently the way they're going to work on that knee.
New Jack now going up top. Smothers has been busted open. Cornette thrown on the outside. They got Bob Armstrong stripped down. Right off the top rope, right in the, that headbutt, right in the ribs. 187 is what they call that?
Yes, sir. You got to give Cornette a credit. Trying to crawl in there to help out. D'Lo knocked. Look at here.
Oh.
Look at here.
Oh, my. They've got that. Their symbolic flag, I don't know what they think it represents, but they are just symbolizing the fact that they are dominating. They own Bob Armstrong.
Tracy has a tennis racket, and look at him go.
Take this, brother. They've got Cornette tennis racket. And the Gangsters have done their damage. They've hurt Scotty's knee. They busted Tracy open. They beat up Cornette, and they buried Bob Armstrong.
Well, fans, you've now seen all the footage, and Mr. Cornette, what exactly is your proposal here?
Well, you know, it never hurts to take a trip down memory lane when you're trying to sell something, and that's what I'm trying to sell. I'm trying to sell myself to you, Bob Armstrong. I've got something to say to you. I've got an offer to make. Now, I can't get the Heavenly Bodies down here all the time because they came in a couple of times, but I need somebody to get even with the Gangsters that's right here, and they got WWF contracts signed for the next 6 months. I don't have access to the Heavenly Bodies. I sure can't whip them myself, not one of them, especially not three of them. But you and Tracy Smothers, you got a reason to want to get even with the Gangsters, and I, believe me, I understand that, and I want to let you fight that fight. But I also know you got D'Lo Brown outside the ring running around causing chaos. And I know more tricks outside the ring than he's ever thought of or heard of, and I know how to head him off. So what I'm asking you is when you take on the Gangsters, I want to be a part of it. I want to be in on getting even. Let me be your manager. I want to manage you and Tracy Smothers against the Gangsters.
What?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm serious.
We've never needed a manager. No doubt you know the tricks. You've been around long enough, manager of the year so many years in a row and all that. I've heard all that. So I know you know the tricks, no doubt in my mind, but we call our own shots. We're our own men. We want to get our revenge ourselves. And I don't think we need you, Jim Cornette. I think we can handle this job all by ourselves.
Well, I tell you, I wouldn't be a businessman if I wasn't bringing something to the table. I got a little something to add to this negotiation. See, like I said, D'Lo Brown, he's out there running around, and he's done as much damage to you and Tracy Smothers as the other two guys have. And he's a big, strong man. So you got three of them, you got two of you. Tell you what I'll do. I can bring this whole thing to a screeching halt. I'll get you the greatest six-man tag partner that you've ever had in your life. You know, I got access to a lot of people, a lot of names in the world of wrestling. I'll get you a six-man tag partner that can blow those Gangsters out of the water to join with you and Tracy Smothers against the three of them. If you'll let me manage you, I will provide you with a guy that will make people's eyes pop out like pie plates. And it will eliminate the Gangsters from the scene once and for all. I've already got him on the line. All I got to do is get the commitment from you to reel him in.
Well, you make it sound pretty persuasive. And the Gangsters have hurt me and my family. I'll tell you what I'll do, Cornette. If you produce this man who's as bad as you say and a juggernaut like you say, and I think he can get the job done, we'll take him as a six-man partner, and we'll even let you tag along as manager. How about that? But I got to know first. I got to know.
That's all I wanted to hear. I got the man's word himself, and I know his word's as good as a bond. And I got that partner, and all I got to do is make a phone call, and I'll tell everybody next week on TV exactly who it's going to be. But trust me, get to your TV set early, because you ain't going to want to miss this news. Smoky Mountain Wrestling is fixed to turn upside down.
Well, fans, we'll find out exactly who Jim Cornette will produce next week on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. More action coming up right after this.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Ross, Les Thatcher back with you here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Les, was Sunday, Bloody Sunday, everything you thought it was going to be?
Hey, you know, you mentioned earlier upsets and surprises. It's all right here, Jim.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us please take you back to Sunday, Bloody Sunday. It was in Knoxville, Tennessee, when one of the wildest afternoons of Smoky Mountain Wrestling ever occurred. Here's what happened involving the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Championship.
Fans here in Knoxville, Chip Kessler at the Civic Coliseum to report Sunday, Bloody Sunday activity to you for Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Now, as we get ready to look at our title defenses, it was to be Jerry the King Lawler this afternoon defending that belt against the Dirty White Boy. But as you're going to see right now, Nature Boy Buddy Landell makes his presence felt even before the match begins.
But the White Boy got a little retribution on him, ripping his clothes a couple of weeks ago. Wait a minute! There is Buddy Landell blindsiding the Dirty White Boy. Had a briefcase or something. I wouldn't be surprised if there's some bricks or rocks in there. And Landell is really teeing off on the White Boy.
The Dirty White Boy. Oh no, he ain't! You know, I always knew that the White Boy couldn't stand it up.
What is going on here? The Dirty White Boy is face first outside the ring as Mark Curtis checks him out. Commissioner Bob Armstrong is out there.
Oh, Bob, he's drunk.
No,
he's
brother.
Drunk.
White Boy is being helped back to the dressing room. And Landell is telling Lawler, let's get it on.
He's being Jerry Lawler tonight, right? Be against Jerry Lawler, right? Number one, you are fined $2,500.
Landell fined $2,500 for those actions.
You were supposed to wrestle the winner of this match. That's right. Well, what I'm going to do is go back here in the first wrestler I find with boots and tights. He's going to wrestle Lawler, and you can wrestle him.
Well, Commissioner Bob Armstrong saying to Buddy Landell, wait a minute, Buddy. You're supposed to wrestle the winner of this match.
Fans, the Dirty White Boy incapacitated. So Commissioner Bob Armstrong goes back to the dressing room and finds the first wrestler available to take on Jerry the King Lawler for the Smoky Mountain Championship. And that man is Ashland, Kentucky's Bobby Blaze.
I know what he is. I can tell by looking at him. He's what we call a curtain jerker. He's a preliminary punk who needs to be on the first match, or better yet, he should be like the rest of these pathetic peons. He should only be able to buy a ticket and sit in the front row and watch big stars like me wrestle. I shouldn't even have to soil my hands on a preliminary puke like him. But I'll tell you what, Bob Armstrong, just because you think you're showing up in front of all of your moronic fans here, I want you to sit here and watch what I do to him, because when you see it, they're going to have to kickstart your pacemaker, because you'll have a coronary when I get through with him.
Shot to the jaw. And another, and Blaze is basically out on his feet here. You gotta, again, admire the courage of Bobby Blaze, but quite frankly, he is, well, I'm going to say he's out of his league, but here comes Bobby Blaze, spinning Lawler around, right foot, right hand, and Lawler raking the eyes. I think Lawler now maybe is ready to stop messing around a little bit. Will climb to the top rope, and Blaze was ready for him. Blaze was ready for him, wraps him up, count of two, and whoa, almost had him covered. Buddy Landell wants a quicker count. Lawler now measures, oh, Lawler and Landell bump in, Blaze wraps him up, and pins him, he pins him, I don't believe it, I don't believe it, I don't believe it. Jerry Lawler for the championship. But now Lawler is going to take it out on Bobby Blaze.
DDT on Blaze.
Well, Bobby, I guess it's you and me now, baby.
Well, fans, as you just saw here at Sunday Bloody Sunday, a shocking, unbelievable development. Bobby Blaze defeating Jerry the King Lawler to become the new Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Champion. But now Bobby Blaze, already tired from having wrestled twice today, must defend that belt against Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Fans, let's go to the closing moments of that great match.
Fans, we have had a remarkable series of events here already. Bobby Blaze, the late replacement for the injured Dirty White Boy, Blaze beats Lawler for the championship, and now his first official title defense against Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Uses that ropes to rake the eyes of Bobby Blaze, Smoky Mountain champion. Crowd with a chant of Bobby. Really getting behind this underdog here. Bobby Blaze blocks the right and comes back with a couple of his own. Clothesline by Buddy Landell, who better not make the same mistake that the King did in taking Bobby Blaze a little too lightly. Turns him over, cover, hooks the leg. Two and again close, but not close enough. Bobby Blaze, the champion, but how long will that last? Underdog against Jerry Lawler, underdog against Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Landell picks him up by the hair. Off the ropes comes Blaze, that hard boot. DDT by Buddy Landell. Will cover. One, two, and again, Bobby Blaze kicks out. Well, Landell could not have written it any better. He gets rid of the Dirty White Boy. Bobby Blaze beats Lawler. And lo and behold, who is Landell facing but Bobby Blaze for the championship? As Landell said earlier, he was praying that Bobby Blaze would win. Those fingernails to the back of Blaze, who tries to shoulder and power out. Buddy Landell going for the Smoky Mountain Championship, which has eluded him so far. Blaze trying to fight his way out. Landell with another big right fist. Blaze, though, up. How does Blaze keep getting up here? How does he keep doing it? Again, Landell puts him down. And again, Blaze is up. Trading right hands. Blaze up again. Foot to the midsection. Landell retaliates. At ringside is the Dirty White Boy, trying to lend some moral support to his friend, Bobby Blaze, who has been busted wide open. Right into that announcer's table, that heavy table at ringside, and Bobby Blaze is a mess. Dirty White Boy, Armstrong trying to help the White Boy back. And Blaze, I don't think Bobby Blaze knows where he is at the moment. He possibly is still on his feet by guts alone. But I think if you went up there and asked Bobby Blaze, where are you, he couldn't answer you. Meanwhile, the Dirty White Boy chomping at the bit to get at Nature Boy Buddy Landell. And Scott Armstrong has to help him back. Blaze into the corner, and Landell continues to tee off on the champion, Bobby Blaze. If nothing else, the White Boy might be trying to get into that ring to get at Buddy Landell, but might force the champ to be disqualified here. And if you're thinking of Bobby Blaze's well-being, that might not be a bad thing to see Blaze disqualified, because I don't know how much more of this Blaze can take. Mark Curtis, in fact, is checking the wound on Bobby Blaze. Again, Armstrong holding back the Dirty White Boy, and Buddy Landell just measures Bobby Blaze. Blaze busted wide open. And again, Mark Curtis will check Bobby Blaze to see if maybe this thing has to be stopped. They call it Sunday, Bloody Sunday, and that's exactly what we have. Landell fighting off the White Boy. Blaze is able to wrap him up and pin him. Bobby Blaze has done it again. Oh, my! Bobby Blaze
bobbled it up by the Dirty White Boy, and Bobby Blaze is still Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion. I don't believe it. Bobby Blaze has beaten both Jerry the King Lawler and Nature Boy Buddy Landell, and Bobby Blaze is your Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion, and Nature Boy Buddy Landell can't believe it.
Fans, we're back here in the dressing room at the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. It's about 30 minutes after Bobby Blaze wrote wrestling history here today in Knoxville. Blaze substituting for the injured Dirty White Boy not only defeats Jerry the King Lawler for the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Championship in a tremendous upset, he then goes about and defeats Nature Boy Buddy Landell to retain the championship belt. Bobby, I have to say that the folks here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling and for the world of wrestling are already calling you the upset kid.
Mr. Kessler, I can't believe I won it either. I'm still in a state of shock right now that I won this belt right now. When I come back to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, I'm a year and a half older, a year and a half wiser, and I thought I was about to climb a long, long ladder, and it all came to me in one day. The only thing I can say is this is the greatest day of my wrestling career and the greatest day of my life. I'm just as surprised as you are and everyone else.
And White Boy, I know you're disappointed that you were literally cheated out of your title shot by Buddy Landell. You have to be happy about your friend Bobby Blaze. You made your presence felt, though, towards the end of that match with Buddy Landell, and some people would say and help Bobby Blaze in retaining the championship here today.
Well, first of all, I didn't help Bobby Blaze win anything. All I did was prevent Nature Boy Buddy Landell from cheating like he always does, like he's done everybody else, and it's a hell of a kid. No, it's a hell of a young man right here.
Fans, there you have it here from the...
I'd like to say something. My wife just had a new baby. He's 2 weeks old. Drake, Daddy's bringing home the gold tonight. That's all. I just want to say hello to my son, Drake.
You see this, Bobby Blaze? This is blood. But it's not my blood, son. It's your blood, Bobby Blaze. It's you that got your head busted open and beat to a frazzle right in the middle of the ring. But did I win the belt? No. Why didn't I win the belt? Because it took Bob Armstrong. It took the Dirty White Boy. It took Jerry Lawler, the referee, the wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's a conspiracy going on. It's like Dallas in 61. It's a conspiracy. But I'm in the middle of it, and I don't like it. And I can be a thorn in people's flesh. I can be a mean and nasty guy. Don't let the suits and ties fool you, Bobby Blaze. So it's coming down to this, punk. See, I'm used to Cadillacs, diamond rings, and limousines, and women's, and jet flying, and all of that. I'm not used to getting beat, son. I'm not used to that. But what you are used to is pitching hay and running ridges and moonshine, you punk from Ashland, Kentucky. So I'm telling you this. I'll put up my car, which is a Mercedes-Benz, not a moped like you drive. I'll put up my rings, my watches, my firstborn. I don't care what I have to do. I'll sign any contract just to get you back in the ring. And brother, when I do, let me promise you one thing before God right now. Lightning don't strike in the same place twice. Wear that belt proudly while you can. Because the next time I get you in the ring, you piece of I'm going to rip your stinking head off, and I'm going to spit in your neck. And then you can go home to your new two-year-old baby Drake and tell him when you're sucking soup out of a straw for about 6 months in intensive care that the Nature Boy Buddy Landell took care of you. Got it?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with the gangsters. As we know, Jim Cornette will bring a mystery partner to the big six-man tag team matchup at the Bluegrass Brawl. Does that concern you in the least?
Do I look concerned? Yeah. Jim Cornette done tried every possible trick and ain't nothing working. We done beat the Rock and Roll Express. We beat the Heavenly Bodies. You don't see them. We done beat up all the Armstrong, Brad, Bob, Steve, Grumpet, Dopet, Goofet, and now he gonna go and get a mystery partner. Do I look concerned? I ain't worried about Cornette. I ain't worried about no Mr. Partner. I ain't worried about no redneck he can put in front of the gangster. It's only three of us here, but it's a whole lot of us that I can go and get. And if need be, I can bring a whole busload up here. I bring so many of us up here, you would think we was making a Tarzan movie. So, partner, if you want some, come on, get some, because I'm letting you know now, the gangsters here to be had. Cornette, I don't care who you go and get. You can get your big fat mama in Louisville, Kentucky, and roll her down to the ring. We'll beat her just like we beat you. You want some? Come on, partner. We ready.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll find out next week who that mystery partner will be. For Les Thatcher, I'm Jim Ross. So long, everybody.
Good guys and bad guys and in between. Don't mean a thing till you step in the ring.